Gate.
Twins.
Oumoulay Ismaël regime. He was the first Moroccan king who decided to give more importance to the policy of interior so that to maintain peace and order. So by the help of those underground canals, the water comes from the High Atlas Mountains, from the Middle Atlas. So to the right side, that's what we're gonna visit, the stables and the granary. In front of us, the ruins of the royal palace of Moulay Ismaël. But because of that earthquake again of Lisboa in 1755, all the roofs of the stables, they were completely collapsed or damaged, but not of the granaries like the ones in here.
Moulay Ismaël, a contemporary of Louis XIV of France, was one of the few sultans to get the whole of Morocco under his control. At his palace at Meknès, he kept 12,000 horses. He developed an elaborate system using a water wheel to draw water for his precious horses. The granary was huge, as were the stables. Apparently, one man was all he needed to keep an eye on his horses at any one time, because of the ingenious design of his stables. They were built to radiate outwards at an angle. If you stood at a particular spot in front of the stables, you were supposed to be able to see all the horses from there.
Cool. And to be served for the 12,000 horses, I will show you a system in here. And they said that they had three servants, but those three maids with their whippers. So they kept whipping the animals to make carry very fast and to have more and more water going to the 12,000 horses.
The gate Al Mansour and market inside.
Walking through the souks of Meknès was a heady experience indeed. We jostled with the crowds to take in the many sights. There was an amazing variety of olives. There were red ones, pink, green, and even black ones. There were fruits like this little green pineapple, which we'd never seen before. And luscious golden dates, which we sampled. And there were large trays of nuts and mounds of spices in all colors. And of course, not to be missed, were perfumes for the ladies.
Hotel Zaki in Meknès, where we shall have our lunch. The view from the Zaki Hotel and restaurant, where we are having lunch.
In our travels, we passed through many roads lined with orange groves. Notice this tree, heavy with ripe, succulent oranges, best for the making of marmalade. one must have a powerful imagination to be able to envision the magnificent monuments built by the Romans at Volubilis in the 2nd and 3rd centuries. Volubilis, the largest and best preserved Roman ruins in Morocco, lie about 30 kilometers north of Meknes. Our white robed guide tirelessly walked us all over the city that was. The most attractive features of the ruins are the stunning mosaics. They've been left in their original position and clearly show the artistry of their creators. Our guide showed us the great marble arch built in honor of Emperor Caracalla, the basilica or courthouse, and the remains of the great Roman villas. On a high point sat what was left of the square Roman forum.
Or rather the town of Moulay Idris near Meknes.